Welcome to the RoboDK channel. Today we will show an example of a tank welding simulation. For this, we have prepared a robotic cell with an ABB welding robot and a single axis positioner. Let's start by synchronizing our positioner with the robot. After that, we will add a reference frame that will help us to correctly position the part with respect to the rotation axis. We have prepared a model of a cylinder. We need to model the welding process for two circular welds and one linear weld. We will be using RoboDK's CAD plugin for Fusion 360. Let's make sure that the part is positioned correctly relative to the zero of the coordinate system. This will allow us to correctly attach the model to the previously created work frame. Now, let's export the tank model directly to the RoboDK station. We can see that the model was imported correctly and attached to the work frame, which is located at the center of the positioner flange. Next, let's export the weld path. First, select the appropriate curves. Then, select the surface to set the tool normals. As we can see, the import is done correctly. Now we need to create a curve follow project in which we use the imported curves to create the welding trajectories. Let's enable optimization for path planning. Considering the use of a positioner, we will use fixed TCP position without compensation. Let's check the result. Set the TCP start point and orientation explicitly. Now, let's create a trajectory for a straight seam. Exclude the use of positioner rotation and explicitly set the end point of the previous trajectory as the start of the new one. Let's check the result. Now we will create a trajectory for the second circular seam. We will use the same settings as for the first one. Test the result. Now we will start the welding add-in and select the necessary welding modes that we are going to use. Let's change the names of the modes as they should be different and set the parameters we need to use. In this example, we use the templates for the welding instructions of the ABB robots. Next, for each of curve follow projects, we will select and apply a couple of instructions for the welding start and welding end. To update the programs, select the appropriate curve follow projects and press keyboard shortcut Ctrl plus U. We can check how the programs have changed by expanding the list of instructions and making sure that the necessary welding commands have been added. Now we can build a visualization for our welding trajectories and use the trace checkbox to evaluate how the weld material is applied as program executes. Now let's choose a suitable post-processor and see how the generated program with welding commands looks like. We can see that the parameters set with the welding add-in are used. Thank you for your attention and see you soon.